Anna, mira papá. Mira papá.
Yep.
Dad, my scratch isn't working.
What?
Oh my god! Oh my god, are you kidding me? Are you shitting me?
Where do you think I've been?
Oh my god.
No, I came and stole the truck last night for no reason.
We're not out there, but we're in socks.
Smack him too. He's involved in this as much as I am. Oh, come
oh
here.
Oh my god, are you serious, John?
Jackie, I have a surprise for you.
Oh my god! Why you keep doing that to me? Little man, don't let it to me all the time. Oh, oh little man.
She says she hates surprises.
I told her she's gonna
hate you. He keeps doing this to her.
I missed you.
I was like Maggie, speechless. It was a great morning, and it's different than seeing them on video.
Scott Vail was a native of Kershaw, South Carolina, who entered the United States Army in 1991 as an infantryman. He has served tours of duty in Germany, Qatar, Afghanistan, Kuwait, and is currently stationed with the 36th Signal Battalion at Camp Carroll in Korea. Sergeant Kershaw's Vail's awards and decorations include the Meritorious Service Medal and the National Defense Service Medal with Bronze Star. Gamecock fans, let's welcome Sergeant Vail's wife, Tammy, and their three children, Ashley, Brianna, and Cameron. All right, Tammy, Ashley, Brianna, and Cameron, turn your attention, please, to the video board for this special message.
Hey, guys. Love and miss you. I have to say I'm glad that we're the ones that were chosen to be recognized today. People don't realize the sacrifices that you guys make as a family to myself and to the military. To my wife, the sacrifices you make are just unbelievable. You sacrificed your job, you sacrificed your friends that you grew up with, and especially getting to be home with your family. And to my children, I just can't believe the stuff that you have to go through. It seems like every time that you get into a new school and you make new friends, you turn around and have to leave. Most fathers pride themselves in wanting their family to look up to them. But I have to admit that I'm the one that looks up to y'all. I'd like to thank the University of South Carolina and the Columbia Metropolitan Airport for giving my I really would like to be here to watch the Gamecocks beat up on the Dogs today. I'd like to say something special to Tammy. Maybe I know you're probably getting a little emotional right now out there on the field, but you need to let that go. Enjoy this day. You've earned it. And just keep in mind that my tour is almost over, and I'll see you real, real soon.
It's a big setup happening all around 8-year-old Elijah Murray Howard.
He has no clue. He thinks that another student in another class is being honored.
He thinks his mom, Private First Class Joanne Murray, is in Kuwait, where she's been deployed for nearly a year. But she's here, ready to pull off a real surprise during a fake assembly.
He's going to think for about 5 seconds that you've sent a video message.
Okay.
And that you're going to appear.
Okay.
At this point, Elijah stands with his teacher and thinks a special video message is about to play as soon as some technical difficulties are ironed out. And then this.
All right, second grade, we are so lucky that Miss Erica is here to help us. Miss Elijah, I know you're dying to see this special announcement. Miss Erica, can you come help us, please?
Where is he?
Thinking in there before she showed up?
I thought the match was going to be on the TV.
Uh-huh.
Do you think it was from me? I don't know. When I saw him, it's just, I missed him so much.
He knows that his mom is doing a service to the country, and he knows why she's over there, and so he's happy about that. He's more proud of anything.
Pride and a big surprise. Worth another look.
This is Bruni's son, Michael. He's in the Marines. Amen. He's been away for a while. sir. And as you can see, they're very surprised. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. We thank God for them. And I know this is something that Bruni's been looking forward to for a minute. Yeah. To see him, and she prays about him to him quite a bit. So it was indeed a blessing to get the call and see that they wanted to, you know, unite with her, and to even do it here is even just even more special blessing.
I'm real proud of you, and I'm
really
excited about this. And I know you are.
Yep. Thank you.
Christian Hale is representing the Air Force.
We have a special guest with us today to help us with the reading of the Pledge of Allegiance, or the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance. We have Staff Sergeant Josh Hale from the United States Air Force. And his son is Christian Hale, who is on stage.
I think he went into shock. He didn't recognize me at first. I can't even describe it. It's the best feeling in the world.
It was a lot of anxiousness, though. I was ready to see these two little kiddos. So we had to wait a whole day. All I know is I wanted to come surprise them, and then it turned into this.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
She's been there for 6 months, and my brother doesn't know, so she's going to surprise him, and we hope he cries. Sorry, sweetie. We're on the wrong side. Are we excited, Frank? Let's go.
This is going to be like one of those reality movies that turns into, you know, something like Paranormal Activity. You know, it starts out good, but...
I didn't think you were coming back for...
Oh, no.
I didn't tell her I was coming home.
Can I take them? Okay.
Okay. Michael, look how lucky you are today.
I know. Class.
He's got his own special side of the class. And I know why.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
You're so little.
I can't believe it.
What are those?
Let me see your booty work. Michael.
I didn't write them.
But everybody's got to write a thing about you or something, is it?
No, they just did it. Okay, look.